So you get this all riced up, and this is going to be part of your filling, right?
Exactly.
This is part of the filling.
This is a pizza pie galore.
Absolutely, because it's going to make a big pie. And as you say, depending on where you come from in Italy, everybody had some kind of a pie in celebration of Easter. We call it pizzagena in dialect, which meant a full pizza, pizza piena.
Okay.
Right? Because piena means full. But somehow it got corrupted into chiena, pizza chiena. So there are many ways to say it. There are many dialect versions of this. So this is yours, the pizza di carnevale.
Right.
And yes, we ate this on Holy Saturday, right after the big veil of sorrow was lifted, right?
Right. Because for all of Lent in the old days, you couldn't not just have meat, but you couldn't have the eggs, you couldn't have the milk, you couldn't have the cheese. So after 40 days, wow, this tasted sumptuous.
Well, what could I do while you're doing that?
Oh, good question. Why don't you start with one of our ingredients. We're going to have eight eggs.
And eight eggs.
The secret to this is you've really got to whip those eggs well.
Okay, can I do it by hand?
Absolutely.
Okay.
And it's a great alternative to if you want to get away from the traditional eggs and toast and you want to have something different.
Okay. Now,
one
is
more.
This enough or does it have to be creamier?
Keep going.
Okay, what about this cheese here
see? Yeah, we have a half cup of pecorino.
Does that go in here?
Absolutely. Why don't you mix that in?
Okay, put that in. And we should tell everyone that pecorino cheese is a sheep's milk cheese, right? So we want to make sure we control the salt in this, I'm assuming, because this is a salty cheese.
Yeah, you don't want to come back and add salt to the recipe.
Right,
maybe a little pepper to taste, but it's got plenty of salt already. And you can see, I just did four cups, and it's rather easy.
Carnevale.
Right.
Va, right? Go away. Carne means meat, so it makes perfect sense to call this pizza di carnevale because it's a Lenten thing where you remembered you just said that you couldn't eat meat during Lent.
Exactly.
So pizza di carnevale. Okay.
Okay.
So you have this. Now what?
We have already browned about a pound and a half, and it sounds like a lot, but it really comes nice. Pound and a half of Italian sausage.
Okay.
You might like it spicy. This is mild, so you just throw it right in here.
So that goes in.
Okay.
Do these eggs go in now?
Yes.
Are they whipped enough?
They're perfect.
Okay. What else goes in?
Okay. And then we have cubed mozzarella.
Cubed
mozzarella cheese.
Yes. And this, I'm assuming, is cow's milk mozzarella.
It is.
Okay.
All right.
That's good. So that was a whole pound?
Yes.
A pound of mozzarella.
Okay.
And now just
mix it up.
Wow.
And
you want a little pepper with that, don't you?
Please.
Okay, let me get you a little pepper. So you are teaching your children how to do this now.
Exactly. And it's a lot of fun because they love those gooey ingredients.
All right, now I'm assuming that we're going to have to make some type of a crust for this.
Okay. And I think we're actually ready. This just needs a little bit more mixing.
All right, well, I can mix that for you while you do the dough. So your pan, I got it ready for you because I got your memo.
Yes.
So you're doing this. Let me wipe this up for you so you have a
very
clean
courteous
surface. Okay.
One of the keys to this recipe is to use a springform pan.
Mm-hmm.
It comes so nice when you take the spring off, and then it just looks so regal on the
Looks like a 10 inch.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. And
so
it's already been pre-greased.
Yeah. Okay.
And now we're gonna roll out our dough and make our pie, which the kids love. I mean, this is
which you brought with you in the car.
Yes.
Okay. So it's all ready to go. Do you
when
punch
that exhaust
it down?
Is going, it rises so well. Believe me.
You don't need to punch it down.
No. I normally don't. All right. You're just gonna divide it in half, but cheat a little bit on one side, and the one side with a little bit more, that's going to be your bottom. So let's pull that out here.
Okay.
Give me a hand there.
Yep. We'll save this other half for the top,
right?
Okay. So I'll keep that down here.
And I always use wax paper.
Okay.
That's for a guy who's all thumbs like me.
Here you go.
That's an easy way to...
Some wax paper.
Yeah. Okay. Great. Okay. So put that on bottom.
So that's looking very good.
Okay.
I think you have that rolling technique down really well. Must be some karma going on in that rolling pin.
Agreed.
The mattarello. That's called the mattarello. Okay.
I always know it's go wash the dishes, if you know what I mean.
Is it wide enough, do you think?
I think so.
Okay, so now.
Okay, all right. So if you'll hold that, I'm just going to peel this back.
Can I help you?
Yeah.
All right, we'll take the paper off.
Okay.
That keeps it very clean and easy. And we'll save that for your second piece. And now you need this.
All right, here we go. So you just flip
it
up.
I'll say Hail Mary while you get that in. Okay.
Just flip it up. And again, you said the key word, which is slack.
Slack.
Yep.
Yeah. So just shimmy off that paper.
All right.
There you go. Give it some slack now so you can play with it. Now I'll take this out of your way.
Now this is what the kids love to do. Then they get to pat it down nice and easy.
Mm-hmm.
And you really want to build up the side walls because they want to hold all that filling in.
And it's a very soft dough. Yeah. So it because it has all that olive oil in it. And originally, I would say that this pie probably was made with lard.
If you absolutely.
If you go way back,
right.
This
but
was
there's
not
some
made
traditions where we're glad to move yeah. have moved on from.
All right, well, that looks good. I think now we can get the filling
right,
in, huh?
Great. Now, this you have to do with love.
Okay.
All right? Because all right. otherwise, it goes everywhere.
Okay, so you have to, you just, oh, came, that, just yeah. can't dump
no,
it in.
No, you just can't dump it in.
Okay.
Lovingly.
All right, spoon it in.
You want
to? So you have to lovingly. So let me help you spoon that.
All right.
Let me see if I can spread it for you while you're
beautiful.
Spooning. You spoon and I'll spread.
So before Lent, the tradition was in our part of Italy that you would have the sausage because the pig would have just been killed,
mm-hmm,
okay?
Mm-hmm.
And then at the end of Lent, after 40 days and the pig has cured, then you would have had all of the cured meats,
right.
like the salami. Today in America we say pepperoni,
yes,
but all of the cured meats.
Uh-huh. If you say pepperoni in Italy, you're getting peppers,
right.
not salami,
now,
right? So again, you know, a lot of these foods go along with religion, they go along with tradition and culture. So there's always a reason why something is the way it is. That's good. And now we can pull that off.
You know, Mariana, some people are intimidated by cooking with ricotta because sometimes it can come a little too soggy.
Mm-hmm.
But one of the things that
yours is very dry.
It is. If you need to drain it, do so. Don't be intimidated
yes.
by it.
Yeah. And I see you've got an interesting name for this.
Yes.
It's called
Arcangelo.
Arcangelo. Now why does it have that name?
Well, because Saint Michael the Archangel is our patron saint from our part of Italy and Campania.
So
the Sorrentine coast and our hometown of Alevano su Tusciano.
Oh, well, what a very good idea that was.
Yeah, so you just...
So here, maybe if you
got
use
a knife,
a,
yes, well,
you
you're
just
a professional.
Use a knife to take that off.
That's another thing to wash in my house, you know
okay.
what I mean?
There you go.
Okay.
Now you want to press this into the pie, right?
Right. As Mom would say, two fingers, forefinger and thumb. Get it and really connect the bottom and the top.
And the top.
Because that'll seal it all, the filling right in.
I'm curious to know what you're going to do on the top here. You don't do an egg wash or anything?
You can. I prefer not to.
That looks beautiful.
I think it comes golden just the way it is.
Okay.
All right.
We need a little slit there, do we?
Yes.
Okay.
And while you do that.
Allow some venting to go on while this pie is cooking.
Earlier today, you shared one of your family traditions.
We're going to put a little cross
it's
on
top.
Old
school.
Yeah. All right, so you make the cross, and
okay.
I'm going to put this piece aside here because we are not done. We still have to make something else with that wonderful ricotta that you brought.
Great.
So let's put the cross on.
Okay.
And this goes directly in the oven. There's
just
no,
right in the oven.
Not allowing it to rise another time, a second time.
So there we go.
There's your cross.
Okay.
Okay. Well, the top oven's on for you,
all
so
right,
why
great.
Don't you go ahead and put it in the top oven.
Okay.